The memories of love will bring you home. Perhaps love is like a window, perhaps an open door. It invites you to come closer, it wants to give you more. And even if you lose yourself and don't know what to do, the memories of love will see you through. Oh, love, the storm is like a cloud, some as strong as steel. For some way of living, for some way to feel. And some say love is holding on, and some say let it go. And some say love is everything, and some say they don't know. Perhaps love is like the ocean, full of conflict, full of pain. Like a fire when it is cold outside, a thunder when it rains. If I should live forever and all my dreams come true, the memories of love will be of you. Oh, love, the song is like a cloud, the song was strong as steel. For some way of living, for some way to feel. And some say love is holding on, and some say let it go. And some say love is everything, and some say they don't know. Perhaps love is like the ocean, full of conflict, full of pain. Like a fire when it is cold outside, a thunder when it rains. If I should live forever and all my dreams come true, the memories of love will be of you.
Nobody knows. The experience of love can be so beautiful, especially if it happens at the fullness of life. Its intimate, gentle rhythms that lift up our souls. The color of our spirits to sing the song of songs and share the light. No wonder that its moments have been experienced as timeless, as if somewhere in time, forever, has been found, or as boundless, as if sometime in space, our frail humanity has finally come home to the heart of the universe. My friends, no moment can be so profound and joyful as this, for we have gathered here this day not merely to celebrate the love that two special persons have found after a long search and share, but to witness the fulfillment of that love as both shall covenant with one another in matrimony. For marriage is the highest of life relationship, and happy is the day when a man and a woman come together and forever unite themselves in the Christian bond of faith and love. For our God, who is love, always look with great favor upon such a covenant. And the Amens yet humanly claim that the couple shall make on each other is illumined the meaning of God's outpouring grace. As Christ is one with the church, so the couple lovingly join their lives into the one flesh created in the image of God. Let us rise and welcome the bride.
I'll be there.
and cloud.
They become one flesh. On this occasion, Inoy and Smile come before family and friends to confirm the choice that they have made of each other as a life's mate and their intention to establish a home and the fulfillment of life together.
Let us pray. Our Father, bless these two persons as they come before family and friends to affirm the choice they've made of each other as a life's mate and their intention to establish a home, where your love may be celebrated in the family. Grant them a seriousness of purpose that they may be delivered from empty words and casual commitments. For the fulfillment of their vows, may they discern the valid facets of your many splendor love. May your word know to them all the days of their lives, that their dreams and aspirations for life be fine fulfillment and the doing of your will and all things. As we share with them in the celebration of love on this occasion, may we all grow toward the perfection that is experienced in your love. Through him who swallowed the wedding feast in Cana, it is presence that the guests experienced, a joy that they had never known before. We pray. Amen.
Fighting away with the will to survive, dealing with the lows and the highs, day by day. On our journey we will do the best we can. If we stumble and fall, we struggle to stand. Lift us up with your helping hand. We'll be on our way, whatever you do, I'll walk with you, hoping that
The making of your vows to each other. Realize that henceforth your distance shall be woven of one design. In your perils and your joy shall not be known apart. The words "I love you" first spoken shyly is the full commitment of yourselves to each other and to an adult responsibility in society. Ben Qualis Jr. and Ismailita, Grace, Cuevas, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourself to each other in marriage?
Yes, we have.
Thank you. And will you love and honor each other as husband and wife for the rest of your life?
Yes, we will.
My friend, Ben Qualis Jr. and Smilita Grace Cuevas have declared an intention to enter into marriage. If anyone among you has any valid reason to suspend this wedding, let him or her stop and speak now, or forever hold the peace.
Thank you.
Since there are no impediments to your intention to enter into marriage, will you join your right hand and say your vows to each other?
I promise before God, our families and friends, to share my life with you, its joys and sorrows, its successes and failures, in all faith and tenderness. I promise to accept the mystery of your uniqueness and to love you as equal. I commit myself to your fulfillment as an individual
and to your usefulness in God's kingdom.
I promise to love you in all the changing experiences of life as we both shall live. This is my solemn vow.
You have pronounced your vows of marriage before God in this assembly. Now, you may seal your solemn promises to each other by giving and receiving these gifts. Let us pray. O God, bless these rings, that he who give them and wear them may live in peace. May this ring be a sign of your love and fidelity, that in your giving and wearing the rings, you shall be reminded of the vows you have exchanged this day before God and this assembly.
Smile. I give this ring as a sign of my love and my fidelity, and with all that I am and all that I have. Take it as you would take it all of me. In the name of God our Father and faithful companion.
Then I give this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity, and with all that I am and all that I have. Take it as you would take all of you, in the name of our God and faithful companion.
Ben Wallace Jr. and Smilita Grace Quibbas, since you have promised your love to each other and before God and witnesses have exchanged these solemn vows and these symbols of genuine and undying love, as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, I pronounce you husband and wife. The Lord of all life shower the fullest blessing upon you, so that together you may rejoice in the gift of married life as long as you both shall live. Whom therefore God has joined together, let no man put asunder.
You and I will travel far together.
May I ask the congregation to please rise. My friends, I'm happy to share to you that Benjamin Oro Juarez Jr. and my little Grace Lisa Rivas had the covenant of marriage before God and in the presence of us all. I remind all that as a community of faith, we have an intimate concern in surrounding this Christian couple with love and in ministering to them. The wedding is not only a visible sign of a new relationship of love, but also in the inauguration of a new family. In the essence, a small church modeled in mutual love within the body of Christ. Therefore, I now invite you to take a vow of hold Benjamin Oro Juarez Jr. and Smalita Grace Lisa Cuevas and their marriage.
Thank you. O Lord, be this blessing that we give to our children. We who have been through this road of married life know there are a lot of adjustments and a lot of growing up ahead of them. Just as our love for each other and for you has sustained us, let their love sustain them in the days ahead, and let them believe in your helping hand, in helping them so that they will grow together in your care. May the home they form be full of your peace and joy, O God. May it always help others to know you are around and a part of their life. Through Jesus Christ, the Lord of all life. Amen.
Oh God, we thank you for the light in the air, the glory in the sky, and the joy of our children's faces today. Bless all the people who made the day so good, and for their friends who have made share the joy and the work of the day, for the understanding and goodwill of the minister, and for all good wishes and prayers from sincere and loving hearts present here today.
Let us pray. Almost loving Father, let your blessing be upon your children, that join in lawful marriage, sanctify them and their life, their home and their office for your glory. Maintain them in love to you and to each other, and send upon their home the fullness of prosperity, quietness and peace. Guide their steps, protect them in all dangers, spare them to one another in health and happiness through many days, and grant them an inheritance in your everlasting kingdom, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
And lead us not
congratulations, but deliver us from evil.
Benjamin Uhuru Qualis Jr., Melita Grace Lisa Cuevas, accept this Bible as a gift of the community of faith. It embodies God's guiding print, nurture, witnessing to the acts of God in human history. Read, meditate, understand, and make it a lamp into your way. Strive to build a home upon its vision of most humanly fulfilling life, upon God's word, which shall fill you with spirit and life. These are tokens of God's sustaining care. May always remind you that material goods are necessary for your bodily existence, as love and other spiritual gifts are to your souls. May you always understand these blessings are from God, receiving the same with grateful hearts and by being good stewards of God's gift. Covered by this veil, which is a symbol of God's care and protection, that will enable you to overcome life's trials and challenges. It is also a token of our affirmation of your privacy and marriage. It expresses our commitment to safeguard your relationship of love from unwarranted intrusion by others. And be bound by this cord which symbolizes God's immeasurable love, binding you as one, united in Him, so that in His love you may also love others in the same manner that you have been loved by God through Jesus Christ. This cord also symbolizes our commitment to promote intimacy between you, so that your intimate relationships will intensify your capacity to love God and others, and becomes a place of learning and showing meaning of God's love. May you grow in the safety, peace, and completeness of such intimacy, sharing one life, one story, and the greater story of God in Jesus Christ.
Let us commit Ben Qualis Jr. and Ismaelita Grace Cuevas to God. Almighty God, creator of the universe, maker of man and woman in your image and likeness, source of blessing for married life, we humbly pray to you for this couple. May your fullest blessing come upon them Do not say me together, rejoice in your cheerful married life. May they be noted for their good lives and be filled with the virtues of faith, hope, and love. Lord, may they both praise you when they are happy and turn to you and their sorrows. May they be glad that you help them in their work and know that you are with them in their need. May they become one in heart and mind as witnesses to your presence in their marriage and us to create a home together. May they pray to you and the community of the church and be your living witnesses in the world. And may they reach old age and the company of their families and their friends and come at last to the kingdom of heaven. Amen.
Love will be our home.
let the sponsors of this rise. Dear sponsors, Mr. and Mrs. Benjamin Orok Wallace Jr. hold you in highest esteem. We see in you and your family relationship a model of what we wish to emulate in the new home that we are establishing. May you continue to merit that esteem as you continue to watch over them with your concern and love.
Dear friends, may we present to you Mr. and Mrs. Benjamin Wallace Jr. Over from now on, live a new life together. Your presence here is an acknowledgement of your personal interest and concern for their happy home. May you continue to follow their new life together with the same interest and concern. Let us all rise to praise the greatness of their love.
Friends, our loving Father, the source of all love, we pray that you will keep us in your perfect love always. Amen.